Welcome back to Dark Chronicle, and we're continuing with the Starlight Canyon. We're almost at a dead end, which is usually a good time to head back though. So we're just gonna go and make our way there first. So this again is called Dangerous Treasure Chest, so one of the treasure chests in this floor is going to be one of the giant mimics again. There's a bonus medal for clearing this place only using Monica's sword, but considering the fact that there's this big elephant here that takes about a minute to kill with Monica, we're not gonna bother with that. So we almost have 1,400 experience with the ride pod, which is going to be enough to get the next core, which will hopefully allow us to equip one of those other best items that I have. But we're just going to continue going around mostly with the ride pod here for the general speed. When he has 1,400, then I'll swap out of him and we'll just go kill some stuff normally. Yeah, so the ride pod with a ranged weapon is definitely the best way of using him. Because even though you can't defend from stuff, you can just kill stuff while hovering around at mad speed. And but if we hit a dead end, it's not really a problem because we can get right back there in a few seconds. So yeah, it's definitely worth getting at least either the buggy or this hover machine as soon as you can. Even though making this one does actually take quite a while in the game without the photo album. Oh, the main problem is still like hovering past the treasure chest, so we actually skip them and then damage our weapon by accident. Again, I'm using the royal we there instead of saying me. I need to stop blaming me for all of my problems. Shooting the elephant in the face. So yeah, again, Monica's sword does like 17 damage, and yeah, this thing does like 80 damage, so yeah, it's a lot quicker to clear it with a ride pod, just saying. Okay, and then we see the geostone in the background, so there's a good one there now. And we're almost sitting at 1,400 experience. We'll be able to get that when we kill the big treasure chest easily. That's another geostone. So again, the main goal of all the dungeons at this point onwards is making sure you collect the geostones. So now that we have the exits item and the geostone, we are totally able to just leave the dungeon now if we feel like it. Rather than actually caring to destroy everything. So I'll make my way to the exit. We are missing three chests that are down at the bottom and that may contain the giant mimic. But at this point, since we are really far away from that now, we may as well just continue. If we are missing anything that we need to make Geo-Armor stuff, then we can just glitch for more money later on. We still don't actually have the party member that allows us to glitch with infinite gold right now. I could go and get him, but I'm going to wait until the next time when we need to recruit party members, which is actually during this chapter, so I'll go get him when we're next in the park rings. Oh yeah, I said I would get off the ride pod. It's just so convenient, I forget to get off it sometimes. Shorten the map a bit so you can see a bit more of the action. Ah, there are a lot of mimics here. Like, I know the name of the level and all that, but still. Right, let's quickly repair our gun before it breaks. I will say that I just went and picked up Gerald, Max's father, over there. And as you can see there, he gives us bonus points when upgrading guns. So we get an extra synthesis point while we have him on our party. Hey, here's the giant treasure chest. Let's repair our gun quickly so we can continue shooting this guy. I Huh. Somehow he actually did damage to that guy. It must have been one of the missiles that came from the barrel cannon of our ride pod. You can't guard a laser beam to the face, mate. Right, well, I will leave now, but at the same time, I may as well kill all four of these enemies in the treasure chests that are over here. Since we can get over here fast, there's no point not killing them. And hopefully there's no mimics at the bottom, so we don't need to worry about leaving the dungeon without killing everything. May as well shoot him in the face, I guess. So when you do have a character with you, like Cedric or Gerald, and also thingy, Melaine, who upgrades your swords, it is a good idea to generally use that character's method of attack more and get some more experience on that weapon and then swap out for like another one. If you really wanted to min-max stuff, you know, you would do that. But I'm not going to worry much about it. Did that really just do 4 damage? Wow. Okay. Don't know how you manage that, mate. There you go. And that's the last enemy killed. There's one chest just over here that we'll go and grab. And there's no more mimics.
Alright. That takes care of you guys.
You may have also noticed we just got the medal for a quick dungeon clear. Like I said at the very start of the game, we weren't going to get that at the start when we're making sure to collect all the experience orbs, and because we can't really move around that quickly. But from this point onwards, with the ride pod and its ability to move quickly as well as damage massively, it is actually very easy to get the time reward thing from this point onwards. Well, when I say this point onwards, I do mean when you first get either the buggy or the hover boots thing that I currently use with the ride pod, once you're able to fly around quickly using them. Okay, let's quickly leave the dungeon and head to the next one. By the way, if you are noticing those like 10 or so items at the very bottom of our inventory recently, they're for an extra thing, but I'm not going to get around to doing yet. So don't worry about them. It's basically for monster transformation. So this floor is called Counterattack with the Elemental Monsters. Let's actually read what the dungeon floor is actually called, though. Again, it has a blue seal, so we can't switch to Monica. Little Dragon Counterattack. So that name isn't actually very clear at the moment, because you can't actually do this using Max. Like, I can knock the things back at it each time they spit at me, but I can't actually do the counterattack thing that it means. Because basically we can use these like little elemental dragon attacks as Monica when we spit them at us to actually damage the enemies. But we currently can't do that yet because our sword isn't powerful enough, so I'll show it later into the game. We should be able to start doing it into the next chapter. Right, so we got very lucky and got the ability to see the map straight away. Well, not the map, but where all the enemies are. So we can actually knock these orbs back at them and counterattack. But as you saw there, it did like 12 damage while our gun deals like 45, so I'm not going to bother doing that. So we may as well clear this dungeon out so we can use Monica afterwards. And obviously it's a dead end there, so let's cut on the ride pod and get back. Yeah, like I said before, this is a good thing with having the ride pod, being able to move this quickly. Is if I do accidentally go to a dead end, I can very quickly get back, and it's not really a problem. Like, it's still a waste of like 10 or so seconds, but it's a lot quicker than running there. Right, so here we are crossing the bridge. Well, we would do if the hover didn't sway to the other side. There's also a bonus medal, by the way, on this one. I skipped by it quickly for not healing. And that'll be an easy one for us to grab. Because when we're using a gun, it's very easy not to get hurt. So this is a long path that seems to lead to absolutely nothing. I'm just going to double check that. Yep, leads to absolutely nothing. Yeah, this Starlight Canyon dungeon can be a bit of a jerk sometimes. So compared to the last seal, when we had to use Monica against all those elephants that took no damage from Smash whatsoever, this dungeon is exceptionally easy, because we're locked to only using Max, but at the same time the Jurat gun is stupidly powerful. But it is worth noting that you may not have the Jurat gun at this point, even though you get it in the last chapter, because it is the reward for 100%ing it, but you can't actually see what the, like, you wouldn't be able to solve that puzzle with putting a wall of gates. What am I trying to say? A fence around the third house, that's the one. That's very handy to have a map. Now then, there is a bridge that takes us back there, so we're safe to continue up this way. Yeah, because it's actually like I think it's like post, like the next few chapters anyway, when you finally learn the ability to get Jurak's gun. And at that point in the game, Jurak's gun is incredibly weak, so yeah, they kind of really screwed up not telling you how to get it. Oh, happy clown present time! It's been such a long time.
Shall it be? Very good.
The red box, of course.
Here you are.
Yeah, you know what? I'll take it. I was never really going to use that other gun anyway. Right, now the exit is back the way we came, so we may as well continue here. You know, this floor is actually a very good time to show you, I'm being attacked from both sides, I just have to make sure I'm not going to die here. Just staying shielded while I turn around, okay. So this is a very good dungeon floor to actually show you the properties of, like, the elemental properties of weapons. Just because each of these guys take extra damage from different properties. So you may notice that some of these guys are taking like 50 odd damage, while other ones are only taking like 30 damage. Oh, we got the keys to get out of here now. Hey, the turtle shell hammer. Now, I'll actually explain what that is. I'll actually show you it now, actually. So here, we like can currently go down one of these two paths. We're going to go to the upper path, I believe. I'm pretty sure that's the one I'm going to. But if we actually were to go down to the bottom path, we could actually go along this hammer route. Because this hammer can actually go down the same route that our wrench can go down, and our wrench can turn into a hammer. And it's down to personal preference if you want to use the hammer or the wrench. And the hammer is like does more damage, but it attacks slower. And the wrench attacks quicker, but does less max damage. But personally, I love speed over all else. Well, unless of course we're talking about the ride pod here. In which case, a huge powerful weapon on the beast is far better than attacking quicker. Yeah, it is kind of annoying to stick behind and collect these, like, blue orbs from enemies. I really don't understand why this is a thing with a lot of Japanese RPGs. Because I've noticed this in, Resetia as well, like the item shop tale, where if you want to level up, you need to go and collect these, like, orb things that come out of the enemies. Which means you have to stop in your tracks to collect them. And it's just kind of annoying because, you know, you want to kill something and move on. And it's really annoying having to stop every time. So I really don't know why this is like a thing with JRPGs, but it is. And what was I going to do? I was going to repair my gun, that's the one. And again, sorry about having the map taken up most of the screen, but yeah, these dungeons in Starlight Canyon are way too big not to have it like this. It's very easy to get lost. And that's the dungeon cleared. And once again, we got the time medal. Right, so let's head back to the exit over there. And then we'll go and see what awaits for us at that dead end that we're just about to hit. Condor's perch. Let's throw it some meat. Take us away, baby. And here is Barga's Valley, so let's head in.
Anything here?
No.
It's a dead end. But it feels like something should be here.
And we just get kicked straight outside. Yeah, this is something I'm not a huge fan of here. There is actually something very important you need to do here. And by all means, you could have done it now, but the game kind of just refuses to let you do it. So we have to come back later. So first off, we have to go clear this dungeon a second time. Luckily, we did break the seal in that supplement video that I did. So we actually are allowed to use Max here now. And we have to go up this other path to collect some more geostones before we can do anything else. Because even though when I said, like in the last chapter, that whenever you reach the end... Actually, I'm going to show you... Well, since I've already changed the icon, I may as well kill this guy. Alright, so that's 5 attacks to kill the elephant. So just keep that in mind. And then we're going to try and kill one of these things with Monica. Because if you remember, this place was actually locked with the Atlamelia lock, meaning you had to use Monica here. You're not allowed to use Max. So, yeah. 29 damage. This is what we're looking at here, and if we use magic... It's locked at 15 damage. And of course, Monster is locked at, like, literally no damage whatsoever, because Monster is weak as hell. So he doesn't even have an effect for Monster. So, yeah, we're just gonna clear this floor using the ride pod, because... Screw this floor, frankly. But anyway, like I said in the last chapter, if you ever do reach the end, like a dead end, or one of those main rooms, like we just were in just where it's like not a normal floor of a dungeon, it's a special floor instead, that's usually the sign that you're supposed to go and head back to the main hub and start fixing the future. But we can't actually do that yet, because... We still need to get a few more geostones before we can actually make some progress. Right, let's just waste a little bit of that repair powder by repairing it before we really need to. And then let's just clear this place using the ride pod. Let's just get out of the way. If you want to see Monica clearing this floor on her own, I did upload a video of doing that. And it's mainly there just to show you that this game does have major flaws. It's definitely not a flawless game. But it's not really meant for entertainment, that video, so, you know, by all means, feel free to skip that one. You don't really need to watch me, like, taking 20 minutes to clear the place. We're running a little bit low on fuel, though, that's a problem. May actually have to start rushing this place. If we get like below 5 fuel, I'll just start actually getting off the ride pods and only getting on when we actually get to a fight. And yes, we are wasting like a point of fuel every time we need to wait for the actual orbs to fall on the floor, which is very annoying. Okay, that's absolutely perfect. That's exactly what we need. Right, so there's no enemies that way. All the enemies that are left are up there. So there aren't actually that many enemies in this dungeon, as you can see now. Like, there's only like 10 or so. Like 20 maximum. But it's just because they take like over a minute to kill each with Monica, it's ridiculous. And yes, Monica kills this golem even slower. She does like 4 damage with her sword. And even less damage with the magic than she did on the elephant. We are going to have to head back and refuel the ride pod after this one. But I'll do it off screen, don't worry about it. It feels so good just to be able to rush through this place with Max. So yeah, if you actually cleared this place without breaking the Atlamelia lock, then tough luck, because you would have to do this a second time, using Monica again. And yeah, good luck getting to the end without getting too mad at yourself for not finishing what you started. Okay, we need to get off the ride pod now, we're getting too low fuel. Now then, I'm pretty sure the sun was the one that we went down last time. So we're gonna go to the moon one this time. Hello, golem. Yeah, so Max isn't able to do that much damage either. Like, we do more damage with Monica, but with that said, the ride pod is still kinda needed right now. The big problem with the ride pod when using a gun is, yeah, you really do eat through your repair powder. Have you been paying attention to whether or not I've gotten the key with this dungeon yet? And here is like the single nice to kill enemy with Monica in this entire dungeon, and I accidentally broke my gun because I wasn't paying attention. It is worth telling you that it is possible to break an Atlamelia lock using an item. But I don't know if they're available yet or not, I haven't checked. Because at some point during the game, they actually become available to buy from stores. They're very expensive, but again, we can just cheat money. But, you know, I would tell you to go do that, but hey, if we're going to be doing this as a Let's Play, I'm going to show you all the terrible game design. With making floors like this for Monica, you know? I'm not allowed to cheat past it. And here is the last enemy. You don't have to lock on to shoot the gun, but obviously it helps. So it is possible to shoot the gun at like a far distant target and basically snipe it if you really wanted to. Yep, so what was that, like 7 minutes or something? Compared to like the 18 odd minutes that I took last time. Basically like doubled, well half the time. And of course I got the item to leave off the last enemy. Hey, that's what I wanted. Well, since we are clearing these dungeons quicker now, it's going to be worth heading on to the next floor. Yeah, so it is annoying you have to clear this place twice to be able to leave it. We can actually now get to the next floor, which has a white seal, which means we're not allowed to heal. And if we only use the ride pod, yeah, okay, I'll do that, game. The game wants us to only use the ride pod, I'm willing to do that. Let's just quickly go and refuel it first, though, because we do need that. Now we can head straight to the station with the move command, and this will put us closer to Cedric. What's up, Cedric? Now we can also upgrade the ride pod with you now. Let's give it a better call. And let's see whether or not we're able to equip more onto that yet. We have 120 capacity now. Let's see what happens if we try and put on one of the other items that I don't think I've made yet, have I? Did I not make them? Oh, okay. Let's see, the triple urn pack. Let's go and make that one. I thought I made it for some reason. And let's see if we can equip it. We can't do it yet, though. Still not enough capacity. You know what? Let's actually equip that one now, if it's possible. We'll unequip the speed, and then we'll have a look at how much fuel it actually gives us. So let's give him the rubber shoes. Yep, so we can get 300 fuel capacity instead of 100. I mean, at 80 at the moment. So that basically means we can use it 3 times as long. But right now, we can't do that because we do need to use the jet hover. Because it will help us speed along quicker. But what we can go and do is make the very first extra inventory we made, which was the barrel energy pack. And we should be able to equip this one. And that'll give us a little bit of extra time. And there we go. Yep, we now have 120, so we got 40 extra. That's always good. As the Young Bandit Prasad is currently level 3, I'm going to level it up one more time and then we'll make the foreign armlet. So you, repair our ride pod again. And you know what? Come with us, mate. Yep, he has all 64 skill points back. That also means that the people making us food are also able to make us more food now. So we may as well go clear one more floor. And then we'll probably call it a video then. So while you're in the Starlight Canyon, let's just go clear this one quickly using the ride pod. I have a big problem with the last floor, which is why I've kind of cut most of it out, is just the way that I completely lost my trail of thought. Anyway, we got a geostone there. Just shoot this fairy in the face. I really should have guarded against that. Anyway, what I was going to say was, the big problem with the last floor was just that we were waiting around so long to collect all those experience orbs of them, all the enemies that we killed, that we actually failed to get the time when we're done. So that's one thing I'm probably going to end up doing off screen, is probably actually collecting these things. I may end up just needing to farm a bit at the end of each chapter. Okay, it's probably more fun to just ignore these things and just go after the enemies. Because yeah, as I was rambling on about in the last part, which is kind of why I removed most of it, I really didn't like the fact that I was just waiting around for these orbs. It's kind of... I don't understand why JRPGs do this. Like, not all of them do it, obviously, because, you know, a lot of the games aren't like this, but a lot of the third-person RPGs, like this one, they just have this, like, weird obsession with making you collect the experience that drops from enemies, and it's just not enjoyable to wait around and collect it. Like there, I just want to move on to the next enemy. And now, if I head back to the previous one, look, see, all the orbs have almost vanished. If I didn't get back there right then I wouldn't have got any of them. So it gives you like 10 seconds maximum to collect them. Which means you can't even like clear out a big place or something. You have to stop at every single enemy you want to collect it off. I really don't understand the design decision behind these things. Oh, there's no enemies down there, or chests apparently. Okay, don't have to go that way then. Oh yeah, look at that huge empty space below the entrance to the right side of the map. It's a good job that we found out we didn't need to go down there. Well, we're getting low on the fuel. And right now, if we didn't upgrade the fuel cell from the base one just, then we would now be off the iPod because we gained an extra 40 energy because it was previously 80 instead of 120. So it is a good thing that we're able to dump the extra points on it. Also, it is worth mentioning that on my last dungeon floor, that again I was sitting around collecting orbs for ages on, we got about 1,700 worth of experience from that after just spending 1,000 upgrading the ride pod once. So yeah, basically I would say 50% of that last dungeon was just waiting for experience orbs. Thrilling gameplay. Thrilling gameplay. Anyway, let's get back to enjoying the game, should we? I like this game. As much as I complain about it, I generally complain about games that I like. You know, like, I complain about World of Warcraft all the bloody time, but, you know, I play it all the time, that's why I do it. If I didn't like it, then I'll just be like, eh, who cares, the game sucks. I do have a strange obsession with enjoying games that I kind of hate to enjoy in a way, just because, well, I really love them, but yeah, there's a lot of them that I just feel like it's, you know, getting a little bit
annoying. That takes care of you guys.
We got the time speeding medal, that's good. Right, so it's probably a good time to call it a video here, so in the next time we'll head on to the next dungeon floor. And then pretty soon we're going to go and do some Giovanni. We may actually be doing that in the next part, thinking about it. I'm just going to go and double check what the next floor is. Because pretty soon we're going to be at a dead end, and when that happens, a second time obviously, because you already went to this dead end right here. When this second dead end happens, which I believe may be there, I think that's where I remember it being. It was either there or there, one of those two. Then we'll end up needing to head back and do some Giorama to start fixing the future, and then we'll be able to save Lynn's life. So we've got at most 2 to 3 floors to do in the next video, and then we'll be heading to the future. So until then, be lovely to each other.